Dear colleagues, dear organizers, thank you very much for the possibility to make my report now here. My investigations are devoted to some space mappings. So we deal with the local and boundary behavioral mappings in domains in RN, and in particular in complex plane. Let us to go to some definitions on this topic. In what follows, we deal with the domain D. D is a connected open set. And we consider some vectors X of the type 1 at this page. So X is a vector, X1, etc, Xn, and F from X is vector as well. So we say that mapping is defined in a domain D and take values in Rn as well. Recall some definitions related to the so-called modules, modules of families of paths. So a path is a continuous mapping of a segment or open or half open interval in Rn. The length of a path gamma is defined as a supremum of such sums over all partitions by points tk of the segment AB where the path gamma is defined. A Borel function rho, Borel measurable function rho, defined in Rn n bigger than 2, is called an admissible for a path family gamma big if rho satisfies the relation 2 for any locally rectifiable path gamma small from the family gamma big. Gamma big is a set of paths gamma small. It may be empty, finite, or infinite numbers of paths in gamma big. P-modulus. P-modulus is the analog of the outer measure in the space of family of paths. Let P bigger than 1, then P modulus of the family gamma big is defined by the formula 3, where the infinite is taken over all Borel measurable functions rho satisfying the above inequality 2. If P equals to N, we omit as a rule the index N near the M big in this notation. We see on the picture some family gamma big. To this family gamma big, we take into the correspondence some number, some real number modulus P. MP from gamma is written. One more definition concerns the families joining two sets. Let E and F be two sets in domain D. Then by the triple gamma EFD, we denote the family of all continuous paths joining these sets E and F in a domain D, as in the picture here. Let us consider some definitions and notations. First of all, let X naught be a point in D dashed. Let B X naught R, S X naught R, and A X naught R1, R2 are as always correspondingly, the ball centered at x naught of the radius r the sphere centered in X naught and of the radius R, and the ring centered and the point X naught and of the radius R1 and R2. Let F be a mapping, and let Q be a Lebesgue measurable function defined in Rn. We always set Q equals to zero if Y does not belong to the F from D. Let A be a ring defined as above, and we denote by gamma F small Y naught R1 R2 the family of all paths, the images of which joining the spheres of this centered at Y naught and of the radii R1 and R2 in a ring are big. We say that F satisfies the inverse Polytsky inequality at a point Y naught if the relation 5 holds for any so-called admissible function eta. Admissible means that eta is a Lebesgue measurable function with the inequality 6. Let us to see the following picture. A mapping F is defined in the domain D. Assume that Y naught is a point in the image under mapping F in Rn, in F from D. Consider the family of paths joining the concentric spheres centered at Y naught and of the corresponding radii. So gamma F Y naught R1 R2 are in the pre-image in a domain D. This is family of paths joining some sets such that its image belongs to the corresponding family of paths in F from D. There are many mappings satisfying the inequality mentioned above. For example, every quasi-regular mappings satisfies the inequality 5 for the corresponding values of Q through the multiplicity function n big. And the constant k, which takes a part in this notation, may be defined in the correspondence with 7 and 8. There are many mappings which are not quasi-regular, but they also satisfy the above inequality. For example, mappings from the Sobolev class, for which the so-called outer dilatation is integrable in the corresponding degree, also satisfy the above inequality. In this case, the function Q is more difficult by the calculation and is calculated by the later in the end of this page, the last formula, by the last formula in this page. Let us recall some other definitions related to prime n's, which we need now. In what follows omega being open set in Rk, and k-dimensional surface is a continuous mapping, which is defined in omega with values in Rn. We say only surface if k equals to n minus 1. A surface is called Jordan if it takes different values for different arguments. A cut is a Jordan surface which splits a domain D. This means the relation 10. What is chains? The following definition is chain. A chain is a sequence of cuts with the properties I1, I2, and I3. So we see on this picture the examples of chains. One chain is in the domain D, is from above sigma m on this picture, and the Km, K1, K2, etc., Km is another chain. Under gonomorphisms, we have the following property: chains map to chains. We see this fact in this picture. So we have some chain sigma, we have some chain K. The images of these chains also chains as well. Two chains are called equivalent if the corresponding domains in this picture, for example, domains DM small or domains GM small, contains each other for the sufficiently big indices M and K, and is the equivalence class of chains of cuts in D, and is called prime if the following modulus condition 11 holds for the chain sigma M and for any or is equivalent for some continuum C. Continuum is in this report is a connected compact set, non-empty compact set. So we see on the picture some chain, some end corresponding to this chain and some compact C. If the modulus of families of paths of this triple equal tends to zero, this end is prime end. Another definition concerns the properties of boundaries of domains. We say that the boundary of a domain D is locally quasi-conformal if for any point x naught of the boundary, there is a neighborhood of this point and the quasi-conformal mapping of this neighborhood onto the unit ball Bn, such that the intersection of the domain of the boundary of the domain with this neighborhood, this line maps onto the hyperplane under some quasi-conformal mapping phi. We say that a domain D is regular if D is bounded and may be mapped quasi-conformally onto a domain with the locally quasi-conformal boundary. For example, in the complex plane, any simple connected domain by the Riemann theorem is regular because there is a conformal Riemann mapping of the simply connected domain on the unit disk. But we deal now with mappings in Rn, and there are many bad domains in Rn, which may have some similar properties, for example, simply connected, but there is no Riemann mapping theory in Rn. So simply connected domains in general are not regular for the bigger dimensions, bigger than two. The completion of a regular domain D by its prime ends, we denote by DP dashed. We observe that this space is metric space. So we may to introduce the matrix in the space of prime ends by the following rule. If we have two prime ends, say P1 and P2, and we have a quasi-conformal mapping G0 from domain with good boundary, so to any prime end P1 and P2, we have one-to-one correspondence with prime ends some points in the good domain. So we define the metric, the distance between these prime ends, the Euclidean distance between corresponding points. Points are G0 minus 1 P1 and correspondingly G0 minus 1 P2. It is not obvious fact that there is some this correspondence between points and prime ends. Nyaki proves, the well-known scientist Nyaki, specialist in quasi-conformal analysis, proved that there is such a correspondence for good domains, for domains with a locally quasi-conformal boundary. We say that the boundary of D is weakly flat at a point x0, if for every neighborhood U of this point and for every sufficiently big P, there is another, maybe smaller, neighborhood V which is subset of U of the point x0, such that the models of families of paths for any continuum E and F in D intersecting the boundaries of du and dv satisfies the inequality 13. So such domains may have not any cuts from inside. There are domains without of cuts. And the main result. Given domains D and D prime, some fixed points A and B, and Lebesgue measurable function denote by sigma ABQ, the family of all open discriminant and closed maps between domains D and D prime, satisfying the inverse Polytsky inequality mentioned above. The following state is such that F from A equals to D to B. The following theorem holds. Assume that D has a weakly flat boundary and any component of this boundary degenerate into a point. If the function Q in the inequality 5 mentioned above, if the function Q is integrable in D prime and D prime is regular, then any mapping F of the class mentioned above has a continuous extension to the boundary, and the corresponding class is equicontinuous in the closure of D. The closure of D we have in the Euclidean sense, and the closure of the mapped domain we understand with respect to the prime end boundary here in this result. This result is published in the last year in Ukrainian Mathematical Journal with my co-author Ilkevich Natalia. It's over. Thank you very much for your attention.